and load quality factor of TE10L mode for rectangular cavity. We have seen in the previous video how to calculate the resonant frequency of a rectangular cavity, and we said that the rectangular cavity can be considered as a rectangular waveguide section terminated by a short circuit from its two ends, and based on the length of this waveguide section and the width and the height of the waveguide section, we can determine the corresponding beta MNL mode. And we said that beta MND, where D is the length of the waveguide section, should equal multiple or integer multiple of Y, where L is integer number 1, 2, 3. And beta MN is the wave propagation constant inside the rectangular waveguide, which can be determined as square root of K squared minus M by over A squared minus N by over B squared. Now we are going to discuss specifically TE10L mode. This means that the value of M would be 1 and the value of N it would be 0, and L it can be 1, 2, 3, or any other number. And in this video we are going to discuss the quality factor of such TE10L mode in rectangular waveguide cavity. In this case we can represent the fields inside the rectangular waveguide in terms of TE10 mode as EY, electric field in y direction, and HX. EY and HX correspond to the transverse field components. In addition, the longitudinal field component for the TE mode is HZ. And as we know from the rectangular waveguide analysis, the TE10 mode has electric field distribution as a function of x sine pi x over a. So the amplitude of the forward propagating wave, it would be a plus sine pi x over sine pi x over a multiplied by e to the power minus j to the z. And the backward propagating wave, it would be a plus sine pi x over a multiplied by e to the power j beta z. And as we said in the previous video, in the case of a rectangular cavity resonator, the amplitude of the forward propagating wave for the electric field would be the negative value of the backward propagating wave. Okay? On the other hand, the transverse magnetic field would have the amplitude of the electric field over the wave impedance of the TE10 mode, ZT. And the distribution, it would be similar to the distribution of the electric field sine by x over a. And in this case, the magnetic field, both the forward and backward propagating waves, would have the same sign. Thus, here we will have a positive sign instead of negative sign. Okay? On the other hand, the longitudinal component HZ will depend on the derivative of YX over sine by X over A, which is cosine by X over A multiplied by Y over A. And also it would be multiplied by 1 over K eta or J over K eta. This is the longitudinal field component inside the rectangular waveguide for both forward and backward waves. And as we said, for the case of closed rectangular waveguide cavity, the amplitude of the reflected field A minus, it would equal minus A plus. So we have this form for both the forward and backward waves. This form actually can be simplified as we know that e to the power minus j beta or e to the power minus jx minus e to the power jx is actually minus 2j sine x. So we can replace this part by minus sine j beta, sorry, e naught here, yeah, it is minus 2j sine beta z. And because we say that beta d equals L by, so we can replace beta by L by over d. So we are going to replace L by over d or beta by L by over d. So in this case, the total electric field Ey, it would be E naught, which is minus 2j multiplied by A plus multiplied by sine by x over a multiplied by sine L by over d multiplied by z. L by over d is the value of beta. Okay? In a similar way, we can say that hx equals minus j e naught, where e naught is minus 2j a plus over zte sine by x over a cosine L by over d multiplied by z. Because here we have the two exponential terms are in addition, not in subtraction. E to the power jx plus e to the power minus jx equals 2 cosine x. So here we are going to replace this by 2 cosine beta z, and we are going to replace beta by L by over d, and we are going to replace the amplitude here instead of minus 2a plus, it would be minus 2j a plus multiplied by minus j, so minus j it would be minus 2a plus e no 2a plus over z. Finally, the value of hz, this would be proportional to, or this would be sine L by over dz, and could be multiplied by minus 2j. And in this way, we can say that this actually is j by e naught over k eta a cosine by x over a sine L by z over t. Okay? So this is a field distribution inside a rectangular waveguide cavity of mode TE1 0 L mode. 1 here is the value of M. The value of N is already 0, so we don't have a distribution on Y direction, and the distribution along Z direction is L. Right? Okay. To calculate the stored electric energy and stored magnetic energy inside the rectangular cavity in this case, we say that the stored electric energy would be epsilon over 4, the integration over the volume of the cavity, Ey multiplied by Ey conjugate, dV. Ey here is E naught sine by x over a sine L by z over d. So the multiplication of Ey conjugate, it would be E naught squared sine squared by x over a sine squared by L z over d. And the integration of the volume, it would be dx dy dz, and x is from 0 to a, y from 0 to b, z from 0 to l. The integration over of sine squared by x over a dx from 0 to a, it would be a over 2. And the integration of sine squared l by z over d from 0 to l, it would be L over 2. And the integration over Y, it would be B. So we have A over 2 multiplied by B over 2, A over 2 multiplied by B multiplied by D over 2. And we have 4, so 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 4 would be 16, would be epsilon A B D over 16 E naught squared. This is how to calculate the stored electric energy. On the other hand, the stored magnetic energy is given by mu over 4, the integration over the volume of the magnitude of hx multiplied hx conjugate plus hz plus multiplied by hz conjugate. Actually, this actually the magnitude of the total magnetic field inside the rectangular waveguide cavity. So we have only two components, hx and hz. If we have hy, it would be plus hy multiplied by hy conjugate, but we don't have hy. Hx here is minus j e naught over zt e sine by x over a cosine l by z over d. If we say that hx multiplied by hx conjugate would be e naught squared over zt e squared multiplied by sine squared by x over a multiplied by cosine squared l by z over d. This integration would be a naught squared over zt e squared, and sine by x over a squared, when it is integrated over x from 0 to a, it would be a over 2. So we have a over 2, and cosine by lz over d, when cosine squared by lz over d, when it is integrated over z from z equals 0 to L, it would be d over 2. And the integration with respect to y, because actually d volume here is dx dy dz, and the integration over dy from 0 to V, it would be. So here a over 2 multiplied by b multiplied by d over 2, and all of them is multiplied by 1 over 4, it would be a b d over 16, and this is mean. So this is the integration of the first step. The second term is hz multiplied by hz conjugate. So hz by hz conjugate, it would be pi squared e naught squared over k squared eta squared a squared. All this term, pi squared over k squared eta squared a squared multiplied by e naught squared multiplied by cosine squared by x over a. The integration of cosine squared by x over a dx from x equals 0 to a, it would be a over 2. And multiplied by sine squared l by z over d. And the integration of this sine squared of l by z over d over z from z equals 0 to d, it would be d over 2. And finally, the integration over y, it would be d. So it would be a b d over 16 as the previous one. So the total stored magnetic energy in this case, it would be mu ABD over 16 E naught squared multiplied by 1 over ZT E squared plus pi squared over K squared eta squared A squared. For the mode TE10 mode, ZTE, or in general for the TE mode, ZTE equals K eta over beta. And beta in the case of TE10 mode is beta 10, which is the square root of k squared minus m pi over a, m here is 1, so pi over a, plus n pi over b, n is 0, so square root of k squared minus pi over a squared. Okay, now we can replace ZTE by k eta over the square root of or beta 10, okay, or square root of beta. Let us simplify this bracket, 1 over ZTE plus pi squared over k squared eta squared a squared. 1 over z squared TE is actually, it can be represented as beta squared over k squared eta squared. And here already we have k squared eta squared. So only we can multiply by a. So let us say beta squared a squared plus pi squared, or beta squared plus pi over a squared. Beta squared plus pi over a squared. And beta is already is k squared minus pi over a squared. So beta squared plus pi over a squared is actually k squared. And k squared over k squared eta squared is simply 1 over eta squared. Eta is square root mu over epsilon. So 1 over eta squared is actually epsilon over mu. So we can replace all this bracket by epsilon over mu. So this epsilon over mu, and here we have mu, we can eliminate this mu with this mu. So the stored magnetic energy, it would be epsilon ABD over 16 A naught squared, which actually is the same value here. So at the resonance, the stored electric energy WE equals the stored magnetic energy at the resonance case. And this value would be WE as well as WM. Alright? So these are stored electric and magnetic energies in TE10L mode rectangular waveguide cavity. On the other hand, if we are talking about the conductor loss inside the rectangular cavity, we see that the power dissipated in conductor loss BC equals the surface resistance RS over 2 multiplied by the integration over the walls of H tangential square ds. And here we have 6 volts. And these 6 volts, actually by symmetry, are can be represented as twice the value of 3 faces. So, for example, if we are looking at this face, which corresponds to Z equal 0, and Z equal L, or Z equal D, Z equal D. So, here, these two faces has the same losses. So, we can calculate the loss at the plane Z equal 0 only, and multiply it by 2. In a similar way, here, the plane x equals 0, and here the plane x equals a. Actually, these two planes have the same losses, so we can calculate the losses at the plane x equals 0 and multiply it by 2. And finally, the plane y equals 0 and the plane y equals b has the same losses, so we can calculate only the losses in the plane equals y equals 0. So, in this case, the total conductor loss, it can be calculated as the surface resistivity over 2, and surface resistivity or surface resistance, it can be calculated in terms of the conductivity of the material of the rectangular cavity as square root omega mu naught over 2 sigma, where sigma here is the conductivity of the material of the cavity. So, the conductor loss BC would be R surface over 2 multiplied by twice the losses at the plane Z equals 0. The plane Z equals 0, this is the plane here. So this actually the losses at this plane and the losses at this plane. In this case, we have the tangential field component is the X component. We have HX and HZ. So, at the plane z equals 0, at the plane z equals 0, hx is tangential, but hz is normal. So, hz is not included here. At the plane z equals 0, we have only hx as tangential component. So, we have hx at z equals 0 squared. And we are going to integrate over the surface dx dy, and the limits would be x from 0 to a and y from 0 to b. Okay? This means that we are going to apply the value of z here to be 0. This means that this cosine would be unity. And the remaining would be, as a magnitude, it would be e naught squared over z t squared sine squared by x over a. A naught squared over z t squared, it can be taken as a common factor, a naught squared. Actually, we have here replaced z t e by its equivalent, z t e, it is k eta over beta. So we can replace ZTE by K eta over beta. Okay. HX squared here sine squared pi x over a, the integration over x would be a over 2 and the integration over y would be b. So here we have a, b, and a, b, yeah, a, b, and we have e naught squared over ZT squared. ZT squared could be replaced by k beta over eta. Could be replaced k eta over beta, k eta over beta. So here we have eta squared due to ZT squared. We have k squared here and beta squared here. And we can see how we can simplify. On the other hand, the phase at the plane x equals 0. The plane x equals 0, this is the phase, the plane x equals 0. In this case, the tangential component is hz. But hx in this case, it would be normal, not tangential. So at the plane x equals 0, we have only hz component. So it would be hz squared, and the limits of integration would be dy, dz, and dy would be from 0 to d, and dz from 0 to d. Hz here, we are going to replace x by 0, so this cosine would be 0. We have only sine squared l by z over d, multiplied by e naught squared by squared over k squared eta squared a squared. And the integration is from on y and z. Y from 0 to b. The integration on y, it would be b directly. And the integration over z, it would be d over 2. Finally, the phase y equals 0. The phase equal y equals 0 is the bottom layer here. And in the bottom layer, both hz and hx are tangential in this case. So in this case, it would be the integration over x from 0 to a and the integration over z from 0 to d for both hx squared plus hz squared at y equals 0. Every point here at this plane is y equals 0. And effectively, both hx and hz are independent on y. So it doesn't matter what is the value of y here because they are not function of y. Hx squared in this case would be a naught squared over zte squared multiplied by sine squared by x over a cosine squared by lz over d. The integration over x, it would be a over 2. The integration over z, it would be d over 2, and the constant is e naught squared over zt squared. On the other hand, hz squared, it would be pi squared e naught squared over k eta a multiplied by cosine squared by x over a sine squared by lz over d. Once again, the integration over cosine squared by x over a, it would be a over 2 sine squared by lz over d, the integration over z, it would be d over 2. By arranging the integrations and the coefficients here, we can obtain the conductor loss, power conductor loss, as the surface resistance over 8 multiplied by the amplitude of the electric field e naught squared multiplied by lambda squared over eta squared. Actually, this lambda is coming from k squared. K is 2 pi over lambda. So actually this going from 1 over k here. The remaining part, it would be L squared AB over D squared plus B over BD over A squared plus L squared A over 2D plus D over 2. I'm sure that if you are interested in deriving this relation, it is very simple by doing these integrations and taking into consideration that the value of k is 2 pi over lambda, and we don't have beta here. We don't have beta here. Ah, we have beta here in ZTE, and we can replace ZTE by the corresponding value of k eta over beta. Okay. All right. Now we have calculated the stored electric energy, and we have calculated the dissipated power due to the conductor loss. From these two relations, we can obtain the quality factor due to the conductor loss as 2 omega naught multiplied by the stored electric energy WE over the conductor loss, or the dissipated power in the conductor loss. By multiplying this by 2 omega naught and dividing by the power of the conductor loss, and taking into consideration that omega square root mu epsilon can be replaced by k, so we can arrange this as k cube. Actually, this k cube is coming from what? This omega will introduce k, and we have 1 over eta squared in the denominator. It would correspond to k squared in the numerator. So this would be k cube abd multiplied by eta. Effectively, this omega square root mu epsilon over square root mu epsilon. So we are going to take one of these two epsilon as eta, and this would be over 4 pi squared rs. Actually, this 4 pi is required with this lambda squared to introduce k squared rs over this value or this bracket. Okay, which also can be simplified as kad, all of them are cubed, multiplied by b eta over 2 pi squared r surface over 1 over 2 l squared a cube b. Actually, you have added a squared here, and we have added a squared here. We have added d squared here, and we have added d squared here. So by multiplying both the numerator and denominator by a squared d squared, we simplified the value of the quality factor due to the conductor loss to this form. Alright? Actually, this form is mainly depending on the dimensions of the cavity A, B, and D, the order of the mode L, the surface resistance of the conductor of the cavity, and the frequency k and e, frequency wave number k and e. Okay. On the other hand, if we are talking about the quality factor due to the dielectric loss, we have to calculate the power dissipated due to the dielectric loss. The power dissipated due to the dielectric loss is given by half the integration over the volume, the current density inside the cavity or inside the dielectric of the cavity, dot E conjugate inside the cavity, this integrated over the volume of the cavity. Actually, this value of J is determined as sigma multiplied by E, and sigma is effectively defined in terms of the imaginary part of the dielectric constant inside the cavity as omega epsilon double dash. And also, epsilon double dash, the imaginary part of the dielectric constant, can be represented in terms of the loss tangent as epsilon double dash is epsilon naught epsilon r multiplied by tangent. So we are going to replace this j by sigma e. So it would be sigma e multiplied by e conjugate. So it would be sigma multiplied by e squared. And we are going to replace this sigma by omega epsilon dash, or omega epsilon r epsilon naught m delta. So this would be omega epsilon double dash over 2, the integration over the volume, the magnitude of the electric field squared d. For the case of TE10 L mode, the electric field of inside the cavity is only E1. So here we have E0 squared sine squared by X over A sine squared by LZ over D, and the integration over the volume dx dy dz from 0 to A, from 0 to B, from 0 to D. The integration of sine squared by X over A would be A over 2. The integration of sine squared by LZ over D, it would be D over 2. And the integration over Y, it would be B directly. So here we have ABD over 8, 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 2, omega epsilon double dash, the magnitude of E squared. Once again, if we are going to calculate the quality factor due to the dielectric loss, quality D, it would be 2 omega, the stored electric energy, over the dissipated power in the dielectric loss. So, in this case, it would be 2 omega WE, which is epsilon ABD over 16 E squared, which we have already calculated before, over BD, which is ABD omega epsilon double dash E squared over A. By multiplying this by 2 and dividing by BD, we can find that the quality factor due to the dielectric loss is simply epsilon dash over epsilon double dash, which is actually 1 over 10 delta. Okay? Now, we have already calculated the quality factor due to the conductor loss and the quality factor due to the dielectric loss. We can calculate the total quality factor of the rectangular cavity resonator as 1 over 1 over Q C plus 1 over Q D. This is the total quality factor of unloaded TE10L mode rectangular cavity. Alright? Okay, by this end, we have completed the rectangular cavity resonator. In the following video, we are going to discuss the circular or circular cylindrical cavity based on circular waveguide. Okay.